I'm good, dude. So, yeah, I'm actually going through my roster real quick to see, like, if there's anyone I want to cut. Oh, dude, I moved Jalen Strong from wide receiver to tight end, and he jumped like 3 overall. Oh, nice. Dude, like I was telling you, man, dude, my mom, I don't know if it's because, like, I'm leaving. So that. Yeah, dude, I know, man, dude, I'm gonna miss him too, dude. It's gonna suck for at least for a little bit until I get my bearings, but still. Okay. Chapter. Alright, I am ready to start this draft if you are. Let's go! It's the Redskins! No, they're gonna draft a quarterback! Oh snap! Who are you gonna get? No! The sad thing is, I'm not joking. I'm sure you're not joking. Yeah. The Redskins are the first pick. Oh man. Let's see. Not too worried. If they draft quarterback, they draft quarterback. I have a second option if they do quarterback. Oh, go middle linebacker. Oh! Oh! Dude, I already know who I'm going. Connor out of Michigan State. Throw 50 mid. If he's a bust, this first draft. Oh. Yeah, dude, 75 hidden. 75. Eighth in true talent. I drafted a second. He's a quarterback, and he's already this. He's already like almost as good as Jacoby Brissett. Nice. Curtis Blake. Damn. That was your guy. Honestly, if you're gonna go defensive tackle, you gotta go Drake. Like, I think that might be the best pick for you. I don't know. I think you're not too hurting at defensive tackle. Okay. Nice. Nice, dude. Nope. I got my quarterback. I can even simulate the rest of the draft. No, I don't want to do that. I'm just saying, like, I could. Like, I...
The 49ers are now on the clock. The Buccaneers are now on the clock.
Ooh.
The Steelers are now on the clock.
What happened? Oh. Like a Julius White, for example. But what happened? Like, yeah, that's like saying, I want to make money. There we go. And so you mean you've got your starter, Darius Geis, to be the number two for?
The Seahawks are now on the clock.
Okay. Alternate from there. Ooh, James Robinson.
The Raiders are now on the clock.
Okay.
The Bills are now on the clock. The Chiefs are
pretty
now
good.
On the clock.
Dontrell, dude, the tight ends in this draft were not very good.
The Chargers are now on the
Matthew
clock.
Beyer, dude, what the is
Saints
this draft?
Are now on the clock. The Rams are now on the clock.
Oh my god.
The Patriots are now on the clock.
We had to have. Oh, there we go.
The Bears are now
on
the clock.
Yeah, of course the Giants would take.
The Browns are now on the clock.
Yeah. Dude, he wishes he can have the career flowers. Dude, what is this? Oh, there we go. Redskins.
The Toronto Mounties are now on the clock.
I'm going to review some offers for this pick. I can get a... I can drop down to the 48th and pick up a 5th. I can pick up 2/3. I can drop out of the second round completely. You know? I have some holes I need to fill. So I'm gonna get the pick. No, I'm some needs to fill, so I'm not gonna trade the pick. So hold on. Let's see if I can find them. Yeah, so there is actually a guy that I have my eye on. He's projected to be drafted in the 4th, but he's got late first talent on him. So I'm actually going to take a defensive tackle, Adrian York. He's a defensive tackle out of Alabama. Yes, 69 normal. He's 31 in true talent, and I drafted him at 34. So it is on to you.
The Broncos are now on the clock.
San Diego State. Dude, I'm telling you, man, it's on to you. You might be able to move him out of the tight end spot if you need to. That's good. No. Alright, let's see what offers we got for this third round pick. I could drop back into the third and pick up either a fourth or... I was hoping someone would offer me, like, second. You know? Legit, instead of dropping, like, hella back in the third round. And getting, like, a fifth rounder in return. Vaults are offering me 2/3, but that's like the. I'm essentially trading my third round pick for a fourth round this year and a third next year. And then you gotta love the people that are like, oh, I'll give you my second round pick this year. Just my third round pick. And it's always like after your pick. Like, come on, dude. So, with that in mind, I'm actually gonna just make this. I'm actually gonna just make a selection with this pick. See if he's still there. So again, you know, a guy that I could probably get later on, but I don't want to take the risk of not being a guy. Seventh round projected, late first talent. On Jason, but he's got 8 minutes in. Pass block power, and you know his combine's pretty good. He was first in the bench press, so I mean, yeah, he's projected seventh, but I'm gonna take him in the third round. Welcome to the Mount to Dejon Jameson out of Buffalo. Oh, he's a 70 hidden. He's not a scheme fit for me. By any means, by any stretch of the imagination, but we've got 5 slots that we can put him in. He's got that hidden talent, 20 in true value. I drafted him 65th. Is your pick. Nice. I mean, Roy Burns was on my draft board, so solid pickup.
The Toronto Mounties are now on the clock.
Let's see what offers I get for it. Ooh, I could get a third from the Bears or a third from the Browns. I could get a fifth this year and a fourth next year. I could go fourth. I could get a fourth and a seventh next year. I can just fall back in the fourth round and not get any compensation in return. Now, is there anyone that I... No, that's not bad. That's some pretty good comp. Yes. Anyone that I can grab that would be worth taking right now. You know? You know, I'm gonna trade the pick. For my pick, and I'm going to acquire the Chicago Bears third round pick for next year. Let's see who I could have drafted at that pick, and then we could fast forward, and then we could skip to yours. So the Bears went and drafted.
Vikings are now on the clock.
Rashawn Green. Oh, okay. I'll take the third round pick.
The Broncos are now on the
clock. Ooh, Malcolm Beckwith, 67 overall. Solid pick, though. Oh, we've got, like, back-to-back. We've got back-to-back picks right here. In the... Oh, he had a pretty good comp. Oh, do you want me to pause it? Okay. Yeah, I got you right now. Yeah. Yeah, I've only... When it comes to, like, my fully scouted guys, I only have... I really only have, what was I gonna say? Yeah, I have like eight guys, or nine, I should say nine. Nine guys, but five of them are projected to not be draftable. Like they like undrafted is like their talent level. I mean, who are some of the guys that you're looking at? Yeah, I picked up a. I traded my fifth round pick in last draft. Just a little. So I'm gonna actually see what I have in with regards to like a selection. So. I'm gonna take a free safety. Late fifth round projection, late fourth round talent. So I'm right around where I should be, where I would be now. He's got B pursuit, C plus zone coverage, and C minus catching, which is fine because my free safeties are zone specific. So I'm not too worried about it. So I'm gonna draft Harvey Cartwright out of Rice University. And I reached. He's a 63 overall. He's a 63 normal. I got him. I drafted him at 124, and he's ranked 125 in True Talent. So. Okay. Yeah.
The Toronto Mounties.
All right. Now, again, I'm going to reach. Reach, not talent-wise, but draft position. So there's a defensive tackle that has an early 7th round projection, but his talent's actually late 3rd. He's got B finesse moves, B block shedding, B minus pursuit. And he's from one of the biggest colleges in the country right now for football, State. So I'm going to bring on board Walter Ellis, defensive tackle. He's a 66 normal. He is ranked 84 in True Talent, and I got him at 130. So. And that might be my last pick of the draft. So I might trade. Okay, so I've drafted a quarterback, a left end.
I see both teams filling out cards. You know what that means? We've got a trade.
Ooh. There we go. We've got a trade. Not bad.
The Toronto Mounties are now on
I am going to see what I can get. I could get a fourth rounder for a sixth round pick. Okay. I'm gonna trade this pick to the New Orleans Saints for a 2023 fourth rounder.
Well, if you're wondering what the delay is, I think we've got a trade coming.
So let's see who they go with my pick.
The Vikings.
Ooh, they went quarterback. 59 overall, Tyrell Mills. Oh, they went cornerback, Tyrell Mills. Out of West Virginia. Dude, they actually... I think I was looking at what their trades are, and they're asking for a quarterback. Nice, dude. Get it.
How come nobody's at the podium? That's because both teams are right now working on a trade.
Solid.
The Eagles are now on the clock. The Dolphins are now on the clock.
Yeah.
The Toronto Mounties.
All right.
Are now on the clock.
There's only one guy I'm considering drafting. And if he's been drafted, I'm going to trade the pick. And he's drafted. There's a middle linebacker that was a seventh round that had seventh round talent, but he got drafted. So you're gonna trade this pick. No sense in drafting someone that you're not gonna keep. So I'm gonna trade away, see what I can get for it. Okay. Yeah. So I'm actually gonna trade this pick to the Vikings for a 2023 fifth round pick.
This pick is trading teams.
And that's going to include
the
my draft.
Are now on the clock. Wait, looks like both war rooms are feverishly back on the phones. I think that
okay.
Means a trade is coming. The Bills are now on the clock.
All right. I feel like draft. I will say that. Let's take a quick look at who I've drafted. So with the second overall pick, I drafted a quarterback, Connor Coffey out of Michigan State. He's not a scheme fit, but he's a 75 hidden, and he's very close to being a scheme fit for me. So I'm definitely looking forward to seeing what I have with him. In the second round, I was able to pick up Adrian York. He's a 69 overall defensive tackle, but he's a scheme fit, so that ends up working out pretty nicely. With my third round pick, I beat Dejon, but not in value, as I got Dejon Jameson, a 70 overall left guard with hidden development That one I'm really excited about. And towards the tail end of the fourth, because I traded my first fourth round pick to, I can't remember, I think for a third, I picked up Harvey Cartwright. I mean, spot in the draft is pretty solid. And then to the draft, in my draft, the sixth and seventh round picks, I ended up picking a defensive ball. What? He's a 66 overall normal, but in the to get a 66, can then kind of rotate with my other guys. Solid. So I feel like this is the best track I've had in Madden 20, and not. That is my draft. Sparrow, if you want to let everyone know about yours. Oh, I've been working on adjustments while you were talking. Man. Nice, dude. Dude, I have a lot of right outside linebackers. I need more power rushing linebackers. Yeah, I have 58 guys right now, but like, as I cut guys and move guys to the practice squad, I know there's gonna be guys I'm gonna need to sign. And then there's a couple guys I'm gonna try to trade before the season starts. So hopefully I can find, you know, a home for them. But I'm set. My offensive line is set. Once I figure out, I'm gonna have one offensive lineman that doesn't match the rest of the roster when it comes to scheme fit. So I am just gonna hit ready to advance on my end and get us to the preseason. I'm still technically a 69 overall, but I have a 73 offense and a 71 defense.
Fortunately,
5. Okay, so I should be okay. I'm currently at 5, but I have like DJ Humphreys, for example. He's the same overall at power as he is on agile. So technically his scheme fits sitting on power. So I don't know how you want to, like, if that counts as one of my five. So, like, I have an offensive lineman, DJ Humphreys. He's the same overall, different. All right, can you hear me now? Yeah, so he's a scheme fit at two different positions. He's a scheme fit. His overalls match two different schemes. So technically, he's a 74 overall at an agile, which is my scheme fit. But he doesn't come up as a scheme fit. It's under power. So is that one of those situations where I can't, like, he counts towards the five, even though they're the exact same overall? See, what happened was I moved him from left guard, so that way the guy I drafted would get playing time. But when I moved him from left to right guard, it put him under a power for scheme fit, even though it's the same overall, and as a left guard, it shows as agile. Okay. All right. Well, then I'm gonna have to do some maneuvering once I get into the preseason. Alright, man. So that means I'm currently at 5. I'm at our max. But I'm hoping with trade can fix that. I get it. Okay. No, that's fair. No worries. That works. I've already hit it. I think I hit advance on my end already, so. Preseason week one. like sign guys to the roster. The ad. Yeah, we do. We can do free agent pickups now and do like week four. We can do if you want to do it that way, like the practice squad. Okay, so we'll sign. Well then we can sign free agent. If you want to do that, and then I said, "Oh, we could be now first." Do you want to wait till week four? I can wait till. I was just saying we could wait till week four to do everything still, like we had been doing before. Do you hear me? Yeah. Okay. Well, then we'll just go through. Yeah. Ready to upgrade. Danny Trevathan, get this overall. Okay, I'm just gonna hit advance on my end. Oh, and then just as a heads up to you, I put Brissett and Ross the trade block. No, I said that's two of my three. Okay. Yeah, dude, I have it like wrapped around a certain way just to get to work. So, I need to figure out something. But I don't want to invest in it right now because of the move. Ooh, I got trade offers for Jacoby Brissett. Let's see what we got. Oh, okay, so I can get a 2023 third rounder and a 2024 seventh rounder. And then I can also get a 2024 second round pick and a 2023 fifth. Those are the only two offers. Well, I mean, I can take one of the two, but I kind of want to see what I... Yeah. What happened? Nice. Alright, no upgrades. I'm gonna hold off on the... I wanna make a trade. Is there another redskin I can go after that's a skin for? Corner that I can probably I can scoop up. Chris on the block. I had put John Ross on the block. So I'm actually gonna see John Ross is 70 overall. The Redskins are willing to trade me Ryan Kerrigan and Josh Norman. Both guys that they have on the trade block currently. But they're both scheme fits and they would help me out a lot this upcoming season. And if I trade John Ross, it clears up a spot for a scheme fit to put somewhere else. So I'm gonna see if they. All right, they accepted it. So I traded John Ross for Ryan Kerrigan and Josh Norman. Older guys, admittedly. But he's got an X factor. I'm just looking at something real quick. One, two, three, four. Okay, so now I'm at a point where if I trade Brissett, I'd be able to start Coffee enough. Five for scheme fits, because I'd be at five at that point. Yeah, but I'm gonna wait if I get a better trade offer for Brissett. As much as a second rounder, to capitalize that until after. So that move actually jumped me to a 70 overall. So I'm gonna hit advance on my end. All right, let's be training real quick. So an offensive line. Cover two man, gives me defensive back and linebacker. Then both of those. Nice. Wait, what did the Patriots offer you? Yeah, I'm gonna wait one more week, and then go from there. Its offer's still there, but the Pittsburgh Steelers changed their offer. Honestly, it is worse by like a 7th round pick. I mean, it's the decision I made, man. I'm gonna click advance on my end. I don't know if you've already clicked advance on your. Okay, so that puts us at preseason week 3. Oh, it puts us at week. Before I cut any players, I'm gonna actually review my final offer and get Brissett off the team. Yeah, so the offers didn't change. I hit third. Or New England 2nd and 5th. I think I'm going to play the long game and I'm going to take that Patriots offer. A 2024 2nd and a 2023 5th. Yeah, I'm going to take it. Now I only have to cut 6 players. But I need to see to make sure I have this. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 1 defense side. But I'm really hoping he boosts up. He's close to. Is I have Quincy Wilson, who's a 77 overall corner, at both slot. And man. So if I can get him the overall boost, I can get him up in the slot position and then clear up any have going forward. I'm gonna look for my cuts.
Move you to the practice squad. And then I can cut you. And then I can cut.
We're doing cuts and everything, right? Because it's week 4. Oh. Uh-huh. Yeah.
Four, six, eight. I'm actually gonna
practice squad. How's it going, buddy? You can say that again. You can say that again. Oh, man. Travis Kelce, Jair Alexander was available. Leighton Vander Esch was up there. Like, it would have been nice to go after him, but no. Oh yeah. Yeah, Bengal's actually a really good one. If you're looking for someone to, like, just do, like, a quick, like, oh, I'm gonna, yeah. Bengal's Yes. And then you're a crusader. Our draft picks. Yeah. Yeah, man. I'm not a super fan of actually playing every single game in a 2K simulation. Yeah. But that comes out pretty soon. Like maybe 5. Yeah. We could at the very least do the ones that we play against each other. No, like, yeah, honestly, with those like super quick rebuilds, like those guys put in a lot of research on like what players they can get, like who moves and becomes better at what positions, like they put in a lot of work, so it's definitely, I'm definitely not opposed to those types of streams, those types of rebuilds. Like, they're definitely entertaining to watch, but I've always been the type of person to do, like, the slow, methodical, you know, the goal is to build a dynasty, not to build a one-year contender. So, dude, I haven't even looked. Well, I'm 1-2. No, it's week 3 that most of the starters play.
I have two 4 roster spots, and I have 4 guys on my
my left guard, my rookie left guard already improved in overall. But my thing is, like, do I even try to get him to a scheme fit? Because he's a 70 overall guard right now, but he's only a 58 overall agile, which is my scheme fit. Yeah. Oh, no, we don't have to trick. Yeah, so, like, for example, we can take my left tackle, for example. I drafted a left tackle at a 70 overall our first season doing this, and he's currently at an 85. And so I'm still allowed to keep him, because technically for free agents and for trades, we can only acquire an 82 this time around. Like, that's our max. But because he's on the roster and improved to an 85, I can still keep him without having to lose him. And then I think I'm also able to re-sign him if we get to a point where I have to re-sign him. So as long as if he's on the roster, like, he's safe. So, but yeah, Sparrow, what would you do if you were me? Because I have the 70 overall left guard, but he's only a 58 agile, so I even bother trying to get him to a scheme fit? Or yeah. And then right now for me, I'm solely on YouTube, but I'm not opposed to making the switch. Yeah, so it's life. JWSOFLYFE. So instead of an I in life, it's a Y. And that's Jaws of Life Gaming. Oh man, that would have been brutal. Yeah. Questions, dude. The comments and you know, show, like, kind of give you a little insights and everything. Oh, sorry about that. I was just saying, like, if you want to stay on and ask questions, like, I'm sure we're more than willing to, you know, talk them through. So. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm only carrying 2. Carry 4 halfbacks. 6 receivers and 6 corners. So, who's your other quarterback? Oh, you picked a tight end. Yeah. Honest. Yeah. I mean, it makes sense. It makes sense to get rid of him. Although rushing is younger, I will say that. But you just signed Tyree Jackson too. Yeah, but Oh, oh snap. It makes sense. Yeah, go for it. Dude, totally boom. You are. Okay. So, how do you, let me go. So, I'm actually gonna go through one last time to see, like, what I'm at. But currently, I have two roster spots I need to fill. Okay, so I'm actually gonna have. I actually moved a wide receiver to the practice squad. Take it easy, buddy. So now I have five practice squad guys, and I have three spots on my roster I need to fill.
For sure, Papa Carl, you have a good night, man. Take it easy, buddy. Yeah, well, so spots you have on the practice squad.
Damn. Okay, so then do you want to start free agency, since you need to fill up four roster spots? Okay. Yeah, man. A lot of pretty good running backs.
Wow.
I saw that. A complete ACL tear. Part of the five. Oh, on the practice squad? Yeah, yeah. You know, you can, like, for me, for example, I could sign Marquez Valdes-Scantling. In order to hit him, I would have to make, since I already have my out of the five. Yeah, but he could, but I could bring him on the roster. Damn. See if I'm doing just that. Oh man. All the moves, dude.
Good start, yeah. Okay, so I'm gonna Marquez Valdes-Scantling, and I'm gonna move him to a tight end, yeah.
What overall does he become as a tight end? No, Marquez Valdes-Scantling. He stayed at 77? Damn.
Preston Williams?
He should have jumped. Alright, I'm actually gonna pick up Tremaine Johnson. And he's a scheme fit, so if I need to start him, I'm not worrying about hitting that 5. So it's on your. dude. Yeah, I am actually. I'm trying to help you get more people to the channel. Cause you know the more views you have, the higher up you get, the more exposure you get. Yeah. Exactly. So it's still your turn, right? Oh, you're actually gonna stick with three after all? Ooh. Back to back Packer. Dude, I wouldn't hold it against you, man. What do you mean? Oh, and overall? Oh, dude, I feel the same way, dude. It could be. Like, that doesn't surprise me. Yeah. Question for you. Add him to the roster and you create the space for him, right? If you find a guy with hidden talent and he's like trash normally, do you just find a way to put him there, right? Oh, I was. Okay, sorry. I was just saying, so like, if you find a. Can you hear me now? Yeah, so if you find a hidden talent, are you the type of person that just signs them to the roster? Since you signed EQ. Because you signed EQ, it's my turn, right? So I'm gonna cut someone to make room for a rookie I just found with a 22-year-old 60 overall corner 60 overall, but he's hidden talent. So I'm going to sign him to the roster, but cut someone in replacement. So I'll still need to fill up the extra. I'll still need to fill up the other roster spot. But like you said, like you got to keep that. Got to keep a guy like that on the roster. Yeah. I'm actually going to cut another one. No. Actually, is it cool if I move instead of cutting them? So I picked up a corner right now, right? Is it cool if I move a guy that I would have cut just to my practice squad? Yeah. All right. So I think it's your turn. With that in mind. So I have two more spots. Actually, yeah. I corner, rookie corner. And I'm actually gonna sign a 57 overall wide receiver, Jonathan. 90 speed, but he's a hidden talent. So it's your pick. Jack? Can you hear me? Oh, Sparrow, do you hear me? Yeah. So. Who'd you pick up, though? Tell me, you didn't say his name, though. So, okay. Okay. I'm gonna pick up Sam Koch, the punter from Nebraska. I really did sign up. So, with my last... Yeah, dude. With my last spot, I'm actually gonna fill up that position. So now we're on to practice squad, guys. So you can go ahead. So I'm gonna go with strong safety. What was his name? Who was it? Oh, it's Casey Stewart. Adrian Beach, wide receiver. I'm gonna go Jeff. Right. Okay. Corner. Marvin Taylor. Yeah, the corner. Isaiah Whitfield, free safety. Oh, no, can't. My practice spot's full. Yeah. I was looking at him. No, I said I was looking at him. I didn't pick him up. Damn, dude. Definitely something you can work with, though. And then a 73 defense. 70, but I have a 73 offense and a 73 defense. I lost one. I lost one, but I have to see what position he was. His name is Taylor. He's picked up by the Patriots, so you know he's good. Oh, my cornerback, the 65 overall corner with 90 speed, got picked up. Yeah, I just want to get to 10. So I'm actually going to pick up Riley McDaniel, the fullback. There's a few receivers out there, so. After training, still no one with an upgrade. Are you looking to play your week one game right now? Yeah, I'm gonna set up a separate stream for it though. Alright. Yeah. Nice, dude. I don't know if it can get much worse. Yeah, it happens, man. The Miami Dolphins. Dude, what are you talking about, man? If they don't give me wins, I can stop. I forget, my team's not very good. Yes, sir. Oh, did I? Who'd I steal? Oh, did I? Are you gonna let me know who I stole? Are you talking about, like, the left guard? Oh, man. Oh, man. Dude. Dude, he's gonna be on my team forever. I don't think I'll. He's not going anywhere. Dude, I'm excited for this, man. Likewise, man. End my stream here. Take it easy.